Good afternoon, everyone. I hope everyone is well. I, Dr. Sarika Chauhan, advisor, WIE Affinity Group, IEEE VSIT Student Branch, welcome you all to our event, Holistic Wellness in the Times of Corona. The WIE Affinity Group of IEEE VSIT SB has organized this special well-being program with the aim of combining lessons in both physical and mental well-being and bringing them straight to your homes. Before we get started, I would like to provide a gentle reminder to all the participants to keep their mic on mute throughout the session. Make sure you enter the session with your full name and use the chat box to ask the questions, if any, for our question answer session. We will be sharing the feedback form link in the chat box towards the end of the session. Kindly ensure you submit your feedback before you leave the session. Today, it is an honor for me to introduce our guest, Dr. Nidhi Thanawala, to all of you. She is a life coach, therapist, and psychology professor at HR College. She has more than 12 years of teaching experience. She has represented India and led students' delegation as faculty advisor at Harvard National Model United Nations at Harvard University. She has taught various degree courses at BSC Institute Limited on leadership, communication, financial writing, etc. She has also conducted sessions for contestants on reality TV shows like Fearless, Video Walls, for Bombay Chartered Accountant Society on Life at 60 and Don't Be Afraid of Tech. She is on the recruitment board of Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited, has been interviewed by Hindustan Times, and has been practicing therapy independently for more than 9 years now. Dr. Thanawala, we are so glad to have you here today. Now I request ma'am to take the session forward and deliver her talk. Let's go out psychological aspects of coping with life post-lockdown. Nidhi, please continue.
Thank you so much, Dr. Sarika Chauhan, for that kind and long introduction. And I welcome all the participants. Thank you so much for choosing this among the web of webinars that all of us seem to have. Now, while that we are starting, there is one thing that I wanted everybody to know, that while the session is on, if there are any questions that you have, please don't wait for the end of the session, the question and answer round for it. Make sure that you just quickly type it in the chat box so that it's easier for us to evaluate. And if possible, I'll try and weave it in the session outfit as much. Okay. So to start with, to tell you, I have divided this particular session into three parts. One is the smallest one. The first one is a little bit about the lockdown. The second one is how do you deal with the unlocking? And the third one deals with special aspects of unlocking. So we'll start with the first one, which is the lockdown. The lockdown is something which is quite different from all of us. It is something which is so, so new, absolutely uncharted waters, unprecedented times, because it is not something that any of us have an experience with or somebody that we know have an experience with. See, this is not like a Bharat Band or a Maharashtra Band or a Mumbai Band that we all have experienced, or like an emergency that our parents have experienced, or like a freedom struggle that perhaps our grandparents have experienced and they would have told us that this is how the things used to be. So because it is so new, we have to give ourselves a little bit of time to deal with it. And that is, a lot of time has passed, so I'm sure all of us have come at a schedule. A lot of people who still find that they are still struggling because there is so much to do, it is ideal. And let me give you an example from one of my sessions. I was conducting the session on how to deal with the lockdown, and I was telling everybody that one of the ways is to divide the responsibilities in the house and divide it to the micro level. So when you tell somebody that kapde is your responsibility, it is not just washing the clothes. So kapde dhuna is not the only responsibility. You also have to gather dirty clothes from everywhere in the house. You have to either bhigao them first and put them in the machine. Then the person who's putting it in the machine is also the person who's taking it out from the machine and sukhaving it outside. And the person who's sukhaving it outside is also the person who's taking the previous day ka kapda, folding it. So if you say that I am only going, kapde dhona is the only responsibility that I have, but sukhana or sukhe hue kapde fold karna, that's not my responsibility. That is where the fights in the family would start. And while I was talking about it, that everybody should help out in the kitchen and cooking, right then, you know, that one girl typed the question and said, I tried to help my mother in the kitchen, but she got so angry. And I burst into laughing when I heard her say that, because it is very funny. So one example or one suggestion that I would like to give all of you is that every family is different. In some families, the mother's always been home. Some family, the mother is always working, but right now she's free. Some families, the mother has worked from home. So you cannot copy what works for somebody else. You have to devise something which is your own. So either you divide all the responsibilities in a certain way, or my favorite example is that of a family where nobody knows how to cook and the mother doesn't really know a lot of, doesn't need a lot of help. She doesn't want people coming into a kitchen and doing things, because the way they make a mess, she goes like, "Isse achha to main karti hu, tum jao, tum jao, tum jao." So what the family has done is that the mother cooks, mother is the only one that cooks, but that is the only thing she has to do. Somebody does the dishes, somebody is in charge of getting the vegetables, washing the vegetables, somebody is in charge of putting the washed vessels inside, everything. She only cooks. In fact, there are people in the house who would take her phone and they would put it for charging. So there are people in the house who are taking responsibilities like finding everybody's phones and putting it for charging. There were people who would switch on the geyser for her, put her clothes in the bathroom, find her towel, put the towel in the bathroom. So the only thing she did was cooking. She was very happy with it because everything else was taken care of. Others were very happy with it because they did not know anything about the kitchen and she used to do that. So this is one example. This does not mean that you cut, copy, paste it like you do in your assignments usually. But this means that try and figure something that works in your family. Because as much as we are unlocking, it's not going to be absolutely out. Because lockdown is something which is completely different. So I would like to show you this one slide here to kind of get the little humor started. A lot of people who earlier said, oh, we are VCs and we are poor VCs and we are consultants and we are vice presidents and CEO and COO and UFO and God knows what other things that they had. This is the kind of level that they had. Everybody at some point of time had to do the housework that they had never done before. So if you are finding this very overwhelming and very difficult, it is that overwhelming and difficult. Please acknowledge that. We have to acknowledge what we are going through. If you feel abhi nahi hota yaar, now enough, you know, every unit of my energy I have used till now and I need to recharge myself. Now I can't do that. That is okay. Don't feel bad about it, because that is how it is going to be. Lockdown also brought out the best and the worst of us. A lot of us hoarded and stopped things that we never thought that we are going to need. Okay. Also, it brings out certain kind of trivial issues in the family. People say that I'm fighting with my family. While I'm fighting, I know that this is something which is very small. I shouldn't get this angry, but I still get angry. Because whatever is going through is, of course, going to come out on people who are closest to us, physically closest to us. You're not going to call up your friend in US and start shouting and fighting. It is going to come out where you are, where you see the people. So I wanted to show something to you after this particular humor part is done, okay, on how best to deal with the entire lockdown situation. Also, you must remember that there is always going to be one class of it. Maybe you are a part of it, some of you, that had a lot of majjani life. Okay? Not going out, your skin is like Snow White, sun is not touching it. So if you feel that lockdown is something which is overwhelming and a lot of people want to learn how to be positive, think about it that way. That if there was no lockdown right now, what would you be doing? You would be out in a local train completely smashed. You'll be literally in this much space and you would be sweating, or it would be raining, or both. You are sweating and you were it was raining at some point of time. Or you would be explaining the Ola guy where to come. You could be stuck in traffic. So you're not doing all those things. There was a very nice escape from the entire Mumbai summers that we had. So these are the little things that we need to be thankful about. Okay. Also, a lot of times people feel that there is a lot of uncertainty. That this lockdown also, the first unlock that we have is not complete. And the CM in the last session that he had, he kind of hinted towards the fact that maybe it will extend till June. So we don't June end. You don't know how it is going to be. Remember, you are not alone. You're not the only one who's locked in a house somewhere. Everybody is going through it. This is the first time that the entire world, first time in our lives, that the entire world is going through something. So try and take that easy. So a lot of times people ask, I don't know what is going to happen. Mere future ka kya hoga? Aapka future akela nahi hai. जो इसका बंदी बन गया है, there is everybody. And the attempt to be positive, okay, this is one of my favorite things that I have received, that if you can't go outside, try and go inside, okay, try and introspect. This is a very nice time to take a breath. A lot of us, for so many things, we did not do it because we had one particular reason, time nahi hai, you know, rozmarra ki zindagi, ye bhago, ye train pakdo, ye karo. Now we have a lot of time. So think about it. See if you want to plan your future, see how do you want to invest your money. There are so many things that now you have the breather to do that. So this was a little bit about lockdown. We are moving on to part two now, which is about unlocking. Now that we are going to unlock, there are these two major parts here in this one and two, where you have to figure out how you are going to prepare for it, okay, how to prepare for unlock. The first one is to do with the actions that you have to take. So start making a list of things that you will do once your work starts or your college starts. Start making those calls, reconnect with your colleagues, find out what they have been up to, what they are doing, what is the most from your seniors or your boss, what is the most important thing that you need to work on. Make that list, make those calls. So on that first day, you are not absolutely clueless. You visually think how your college was, how your workplace was, so that you don't much, arey, ye cooler yaha tha, kitne dinon se maine ye cooler nahi dekha, and then suddenly you're feeling very nostalgic looking at something which is very, very ordinary. So on first day, get work done. Get actual work done. Don't be clueless. Don't be confused. Okay? Think about your desk. What paper was where? What were the things that you left incomplete? What is the first thing that you would get start on so that you can jump right back in and you can show result? Because now what is going to happen with a lot of people, and this is not really a concern for a lot of students, but this is either for your parents or your friends or other people, that a lot of people will be laid off. A company ko bhi pata chal gaya hai that itne sare logo ki zarurat nahi hai, ghar pe baith ke kaam ho raha hai, kam logo ka kaam ho raha hai. I have heard about a lot of organizations where a lot of employees have said that nahi nahi, we don't have network, we can't work from home and there. They were fired there and there. So they want to. So you want to make sure that you come across as somebody who's valuable. So on day one, you want to get things done. Also make a list of things you want to find out from the organization on day one, because it's been such a long time that you went to work. So students, get acquainted with your bag, find where your bag is, ghar ke kaun se kone mein pada hai, take it out, clean it if you have to, find your wallet, load it with all kinds of money, all chutta, everything together, because you may not really want to touch a lot of other people's currency notes, so you should have all the denominations there packed and packed. Find out where your water bottle is, where your lunch box is, wash it and keep. So keep those things ready, find where your railway pass is, okay? So even if it expired, I'm sure they are going to consider it and they are going to give you that boost of 2-3 months more. So get all those things together. It should not be that 12 or say 8 or around 11 o'clock you have to get out of the house on first day, and 10 o'clock you're thinking, mera bag kahan hai, mera pass kahan hai, arre kiske paas 50 ka chutta hai ya nahi, I only have 100 rupees. That's not all. So be ready for that day starting now. Find those things, okay? Clear out things, make space. Do all those things right there and there so that you can make most of those things. The second part, it deals with the psychological aspect. The first one was a little bit of the physical one. So this is a psychological one. Get into a schedule. Start acting like you have to go to work or you have to study starting tomorrow. The most important thing is to follow this one acronym that I have made up. It's called SEWA. It stands for S-E. So it is S-E-W-A. The first one is the most important one, which is sleep. An average human needs 8 hours of good sound sleep. Okay, and I know what the students are thinking. Yeah, I go to sleep at around 6 in the morning and then after 8 hours I wake up. That is not how it counts. Your body does know what is day and what is night. So you must sleep somewhere around 11, latest by 12 o'clock. And then you must get up 8 o'clock in the morning or maybe a little earlier. So try and get used to that 8 hours of sleep because your body needs it. You will feel negative if you are not getting enough rest. Yep. So make sure that you get that rest. Besides those 8 hours out of 24 hours, don't waste a lot of time doing things here and there. There are so many other time management techniques that can be used. That's an entire session altogether, actually, which you can use to make most of the time that you have. A lot of time people feel, oh, I was doing something. I don't know where all those hours went by. A lot of times, and this is especially for the students who are binge watching Netflix and God knows what all, right now, ask yourself, is that really entertaining? Is this something which is entertaining you right now? Or is it just you just sitting there in front of the TV or the laptop and they're moving images and you're just looking at it, or you're watching because everybody else is watching? Because if it is not helping you, if it is not making you happy or relaxing you, stop right there. Don't even wait for that episode to finish. Forget the episode. Don't even wait for the scene to finish if it is not going to make you happy. The reason we use entertainment is so that we feel light. So if you're not feeling light, then there is no point in doing that. So start getting enough sleep. The second one is for eat. Okay? A lot of us are constantly eating because we are at home. So here I like to tell you that there is a difference between hunger and appetite. Hunger is something which is biological and appetite is something which is more psychological. So it's a pang that you have that you want to eat something or that you have to get something right there and there. Now, what happens here is that ensure that what you are munching on for your appetite is something which is healthy. As my master's teachers used to say, only a healthy mind can rest in a healthy body. Okay, or a healthy mind can rest only in a healthy body. So if you keep eating junk food or if you eat lunch in the time of evening snack or breakfast at the time of lunch, then that is not something which is going to help you. And I can understand that now all our schedules have kind of gone for a toss because bartan ke liye koi aane to nahi wala, khud hi karne hai, to jab bhookh lagegi tab khayenge. But if you want to get back into the so-called normal life that you had before the unlock, then you will have to set some kind of a schedule. Set the schedule which is as close to the normal life that you had so that you can transition very evenly and very quickly and very smoothly into it. So make sure that you get enough sleep, that you eat things which are healthy. You can eat nuts. You can keep drinking a lot of water, have a lot of fluids. So it's not just something that is water. You can have nimbu pani. You can have chas. Most of the nutritionists would recommend these things. You can get coconut water if you are moving around freely and that is something which is easily available. So make sure you have all these things that will make you feel better as a person. You will feel more productive. You will also sleep better. So this was the S and E of Seva. The W comes to the W, which was the water. So drink a lot of water. Make sure that you get at least 4 liters a day, either water or any sort of liquid that you have. You can have fruit juice or anything that you like. When you feel hungry, munch on fruits, munch on nuts, munch on kurmura or chana. All these things are absolutely, or makhana, all these things are absolutely, make sure they're all roasted. All these things are absolutely healthy and they will take care of your hunger as well. So make sure that you have these things instead of just finding Oreos from here or some deep fried things that you are eating. It's monsoon season, so all of us are having bhajiyas. And while there's nothing wrong with bhajiyas, make sure you have them in moderation. You can't have only bhajiya for dinner. Okay? So if you're going to have bhajiya for starter, you can have khichdi for dinner. So that way you're kind of taking care of things. Okay? The last part of seva is A, which is for air. Ensure that you get fresh air very on a regular basis. You keep getting this particular access to fresh air. Try and get that as early in the morning as you can, because that vitamin D3 is something which is very important and you should have that before 9 a.m. Now, if you can step out, if you are in a green zone, then please step out, or you can go to your terrace or you can go to your balcony. If nothing else, you can go to your window. There are multiple reasons why you should do this. If you do this, one, you're going to get D3. Two, you're going to feel better because it is fresh air. And two, because of this, you're going to wake up early morning. Most number of people, especially students, don't get up early because they feel that jaldi uthke hame karna kya hai. So we'll just get up later. So if you start getting up early every day, every night, you will also feel sleepy. Make sure you get some physical exercise. If nothing else, you can use the stairs. Again, if you're stepping out, you can use the skywalk or other things. You can do yoga in the house. You can skip. There are so many physically challenging exercises that you can do, which will so that you can tire yourself out and then you can sleep well. So please remember this seva. It stands for sleep, eating well, water and air, to get all of those things together. Try and get yourself into a schedule that you had earlier. So get up at a particular time, have your lunch at the time that you're used to at that time. Also, those of you who are studying from home or taking up courses or people who are working from home, it is absolutely essential that you don't lie on the bed with your laptop open half of the time. Okay? Ensure that you do that. If you're working on your laptop, work in a specific area in the house. Now, I know Bombay houses are very small. Okay? None of us live in palatial homes here, at least not in Mumbai. So one of the things, that it could be a tiniest corner. It could be the study table or it could be anything by the window, whatever it is close to the charging point. But assign one place, sit into that one place and make sure that you eat in that one place alone, work in that one place alone. Similarly, for eating, don't eat every now and then, sometimes on the sofa, sometimes on the dining table, sometimes niche bed guy, sometimes kitchen mein. Try and maintain that one place where you are eating. When it comes to sleeping, sleep only on your bed. Okay? Don't lie down anywhere. At the same time, don't do anything else on the bed. That before sleeping 1 hour, you are scrolling through Instagram, then you're going to scroll through Facebook, then you're going to go through Tinder perhaps, and you're just going to do so much more. So do all that before you go to sleep. Personally, people who really want to put their cell phone use to lesser usage, I would strongly recommend that don't use it lying down. Every time that you're using your cell phone, stand. Stand without leaning anywhere like this. Stand properly. Stand in an uncomfortable position if you have to. And that is the only time that allow yourself to use your phone. So what will happen when you do this is that you will not use the phone unnecessarily because you would want to sit down and you're not allowed to use your phone if you sit down. Don't keep your phone next to you when you go to sleep. Nobody is going to call you in that kind of an emergency. And if you want to see the time, there is a clock in your room. If there is no clock, order one from Amazon. But make sure that you look into the time in the clock, because how many times has that happened that you have seen your, you have taken your phone in your hand to look at the time and then there was some message or notification and you went there and 45, 50 minutes went by and you didn't even realize. Okay? All because all you wanted to do was see the time. And this would never happen in a clock. In a clock, if you're sleeping, you open your eyes, you look at the time, you go back to sleep. So make sure that you restrict the use of your cell phone. You can't completely give it up because it's something which is very useful, especially now that we are locked in. A lot of things we are doing via phone, which earlier traditionally we used to do using other things. Okay? One thing that I wanted to talk about, which a lot of people fall into, is it's something which is called as a productivity trap. Okay, so how the productivity trap works is that we feel that there is a pressure to make the most out of the lockdown. That somewhere in the history, down the line, you know, people, or as soon as the lockdown is over, everybody will ask, "Are kya ki? I did so many courses. I did this. I went here. I did went here virtually, of course. I studied so much. I got so many certificates. I attended so many webinars. What did you do? I learned this on Udemy." Or maybe after years, your children will ask you, or after a lot of years, your grandchildren will ask you. Don't get into that trap that you continuously have to be productive. Remember, in lockdown, you have to do one thing first, and that one thing is surviving. Survive this lockdown physically and mentally. Even if every day all you did was jhadu pocha bartan, okay, eat and sleep on time, do little bit of work that you were assigned to or study a bit, that is okay. That is fine. But don't do something like not doing the jhadu properly because you have a webinar to attend, okay, or not putting a lot of focus into cooking because you want to do other things, okay? So this is something that I had done in one of my sessions, and this is a feedback that I later got on Insta. This is something that one of my ex-students sent to me, okay? And she was one of the classic cases where there was such a pressure to be productive, learn a new skills. Some people are drawing mandalas. In fact, I'm also doing mandala workshops. So some people are drawing mandalas. Some people are doing a lot of international seminars. Some people are on this race for webinars. Okay. So whenever they are asked, they are like, so many international, so many national, so many this. I have so many certificates. And there is a pressure that they have for attending webinars. And while webinars are amazing, as I said, remember and do things that are useful to you because they make you happy, because you are learning something out of it, and not because there is a race or not because there is everybody who's going to do it. Okay? So ensure that you don't fall into the productivity trap. Do things which are more important. So like this girl here said that she had not cleaned the kitchen and she was just doing everything else but to clean the kitchen. And that was something which was more necessary than any of the other things that she was doing. So I really hope that this example was something which was useful to you. Now, moving on to the last part about unlocking, how to use your money well. A lot of people do ask about what can we do so that our life will be normal again. Okay? We want that normal life. Now, one thing that you must really be calm and ask yourself is, was your life ever normal? Okay? Yes, you had a routine. And this is something which is found very, very helpful to me. So I'm quickly going to go through it, that people have all kinds of things like the world is changing now. These are some unprecedented times. But the world was always changing. Okay? And our lives are in such dangers. But other lives were always in danger. Yes, corona has added a lot to it. Okay? And earlier, sneezing in public or touching people or going to the mall was not this risky as it was earlier. So I do understand that. But at the same time, you can't say, oh, now we are going to die. We were always going to die. Okay? Or nobody knows what's going to happen. Nobody never knew what was going to happen. We don't even know who to believe anymore, what to do. But that's also kind of exciting because it is refreshing and restoring our beliefs. And at the same time, a person is saying, we are living in such strange times. But we were always living in strange times. Our life perhaps was never normal. And let me tell you something. Don't assume that once unlock one or two or three or four or five eventually happens, you will be in the life that you had in February. You will never have that life. But that does not mean that things are bad. Okay? What it means is that things are new. And new is scary, new is different, yes, but new can be good as well. And here we have a way, we have this opportunity to shape how we want to be. So when you have the time, take a breath, think about it. Again, don't just randomly sit by the window with a cup of coffee and just think. Write it down. What part of your life before the lockdown or before the entire corona thing happened in 2000, just go to 2019. Come, think about your life in 2019. Think about your life now. What part of that life do you not want to do? Okay. What part of that life do you want to continue? Because those are the elements that you can add and uninstall accordingly. So the last aspect that I wanted to talk about, okay, deals with money. Okay. This is also something, this particular image is also something that I have found to be incredibly useful. You can either download it if Teams allows you or just physically click a picture of it and zoom it later or zoom it right now and take a screenshot about it. Initially, there is a lot of fear about Corona. Now the fear will also come back when we unlock. Because what happens is that people think, I don't know if I can step out, or I really like watching movies. When will I be able to go to the mall again? So think, and the image that I had showed you first about, you know, Maggie and other things stopped, it all comes out of fear. Baad mein mujhe nahi milega, to let me buy biscuits in bulk, or let me buy ready to eat, and let me do all of those things. So from that, it's fine. Acknowledge that fear. From that fear, we do have to move on out of the learnings that we have, and then eventually to growing. Now, looking at another important aspect, as I said, money, a lot of people have asked me, and even few in this particular session have, of what can we do that, because already there is some kind of a financial crunch, or so there are two ways to look at it. One, there is a financial crunch. Two, we haven't gone out, we haven't eaten out, and we have saved that kind of money. So what can we do so that we don't spend now? Because a lot of people thought that they will not be able to live without pav vada and pizza and pani puri. Like, oh my God, pani puri. Okay, that they will not live without all these things. But they were able to survive without all those things. So how can we continue? So there are four steps. There are four things that you have to do here. Number one is that you have to uninstall Myntra, Jabong, all shopping apps from your phone right now. Okay. Number two, which is kind of following it, is don't have any wish list or any items in your cart right now. See, why are we doing number one? Because as soon as the unlock happens, all those people who are working for the marketing and advertising and these apps, right now, they're doing overtime from work from home because they can't sell things to you now. So they're waiting for that unlock to happen so that they will pounce on you and loot you of all the money that you have. So they will send different kind of offers. They will say, "Arey, poor you, you've been in ghar ka kapda also. Feel good by wearing nice clothes. Here, take a discount code," and God knows what all. And you don't want to fall into those things. So you don't need those apps. Now, there may be apps like Big Basket or Amazon where you also get a lot of essentials. So this is why don't keep any wish list. Keep a list of it somewhere written in your diary, because if you have a wish list, all of your IIT students, so you would know that is how an algorithm works. If I go and check out certain Staedtler pens on Amazon right now, I will see those ads on Facebook. Okay? So they will tempt you by getting to you into this way. One of the most, also on Facebook or any other social media, you will not follow posts such as "I miss this," or "I wish I had this," or "I want this." Because that also is how the algorithm would work, and you will get those particular ads and those particular messages. And these companies are working very hard. Some very, very smart people, be it in advertisers or marketers or even clinical psychologists, are working very hard right now to get you and get those 800, 900, 3,000, 4,000 rupees from you. And you don't want to spend that money because you don't even know that you're spending it money because they are making you. So uninstall those apps. Don't have any wish list. Make a list of expenses that you think you will make about the things that you need once we unlock. So, and make two lists, list A and list B, or list green and list red. The green will be the absolute essential, and the red would be the things that you want, not the things that you need, but the things that you want as such. So you know what to avoid. And the last one, which is the fourth one, is to make a strict budget. Okay? So you are not going to, because you have the list ready, because of the list, you know how much what is going to cost. Based on that, make an extremely strict budget so that you know that you don't overspend. Because all this while, the money that you have saved, you have not saved it so that you will spend it all later. And as I told you, and I have done sessions for advertising agencies, and I know how hard they are working, because a lot of them are losing their monthly retainer amount. Okay, so advertising agencies are also not doing as good business as they were. They can't shoot new commercials. So they will do all that, and they will try and take out all that money very soon enough. And where is all that money going to come out from? From you. So ensure that you don't give them that kind of an opportunity. So now I'm just quickly going to wrap up the session. Okay. And if there are any questions that you have, please feel free to ask me here. I don't know if we are going to look at the chat box or how we are going to do it. Maybe Sarika will tell us. Okay. The last part kind of deals with how do we deal with the psychological aspects of the lockdown? What do we feel? A lot of people say that they are really, really scared about things. And yes, we have got the mask, and we have so many sanitizers now, and we have different kind of hand washes and foot pedals and all those things. Remember that you need to take certain kind of precautions. Okay? If you take these precautions as a part of your lifestyle, as a part of your habits every day, then that is something which is definitely going to help you. Be as careful as possible. And remember, unlock doesn't mean that now you are Amar. Okay? So don't step out unless it is for your college or your work or something which is absolutely essential. If it is, do that and come back. Don't stop to buy Maggie. Maggie was never essential. So revisit the entire concept of what is essential for you. And imagine that whatever that you are buying is at a double cost. Do you still need it? If you still need it, then yes, it's an essential. If you are still thinking about it, then it is not an essential. So limit going out, because social distancing and staying at home is the most that you're going to particularly need. Also, when you are hiring your domestic staff back, ensure that they are also taking a lot of precautions, because, well, we miss them dearly and we really want all of them back. But at the same time, we want to be careful as well. Okay? So if there are any questions now, please send them in. Okay? Because I'm just going to take one more quick minute to talk about fear. Okay? Number one thing about fear, any fear that you have, you know, some people are scared of dogs, some people are scared of spiders, some people are scared of dark, etc., is one. Asking yourself, how rational is this fear? Okay? So if you're scared of the dog or something, it's not perhaps a really, really rational fear. Yes, the dog is scary. But if you're scared of corona, it is a rational fear. So if somebody around you is scared of it, don't try and belittle that person by saying, "Arey, isme kya darna? Tu kitna darta hai?" No, it is a rational fear. A lot of us have lost people that we know because of corona. Those people would have been alive today had it not been for this deadly virus. So one thing that you must know is that, yes, it is scary, but there are things that you can do to be as cautious as you can, like wearing your mask and washing your hands and maybe keeping a sanitizer if you believe in the concept of sanitizer, or just washing your hands whenever you can, or cleaning your shoes in a certain way. So there are a lot of guidelines which are easily available. There are a lot of sessions by doctors that they are doing it, especially helping out the children and the senior citizens, because they are more at risk when it comes to this particular disease. So make sure that you are doing all of these things together. And as and when you do these things, you are making yourself a little more cautious, and at the same time, try and get it from people that what are the things that they are doing. Okay? Make sure you are in touch with your friends, because the way your friends or people that you like in your family, there are so many things that people are doing. They're playing house party, they are doing Ludo, there are musical houses that people are arranging, and some of these things are so much fun. And when you have that kind of fun, you feel better, you are a little more positive. So do those things. Okay? If you're worried about the entire world as such, we can always pray, we can always chant. Meditation is something that is found, a lot of people have found to be very, very helpful. Though it is not from everybody, but what everyone can do is a simple pranayam or chanting of Om, which a lot of people have found helpful. The more you do pranayam, the more it apparently helps with corona also. And I heard about it and I started doing it. And that is also something that I strongly recommend to me. So I think I have covered most of the things. If there are any questions, maybe Sarika can help us, and I'll be happy to take.
Yes, thanks, Nidhi. Thanks, Nidhi. That was an incredibly insightful session. We would now like to present some questions that students have asked.
Okay.
So the first question is, in the lockdown, people lose their job, family, friends, and relatives. How they overcome these problems?
Now, when it comes to jobs, it's something which I can't say a job will come and go, because it's your career. You have worked really, really hard, and it is an extremely sad part of what our economy has gone through. But the most important thing that you have to remember is that you are safe. The people around you are physically safe, and we can always work on bringing up new skills, enhancing the CV, and probably take lesser assignments which are perhaps from work from home, etc. When it comes to losing family member or friends, that's the worst that could perhaps happen to people, and grief is one of the most complex and challenging emotions that we can experience. But remember that life does not work by if and then. You can't say if they had been more cautious, or if this had happened, then the person would still be alive. That is not going to bring the person back. And I personally know of people who were a couple living alone, and one of them was lost to corona, so the other person is alone. So the most you feel, oh, because of this lockdown, I can't even go and visit them. But what you can do is you can find out different services from their area, call them every day, send them memes or jokes or newspapers, or make sure that you tell them that you are there for them. And that is how we deal with it. If you can send them food, then nothing like that. Otherwise, as I said, you can find out different services in the particular area so that their basic needs, etc., are taken care of. Because that person is the person who's left behind is also somebody who's extremely scared. Okay? The ideal thing to do, and I will like to talk about one of the things here, that there was an anthropologist called Margaret Mead. And she was in a lecture asked that when, according to her, human civilization starts, and I have found this to be very, very interesting, and some of my students also have, so I would like at least the students' part to be attention here, that she was asked, when, according to you, did human civilization start? And a lot of people thought that she will talk about when the wheel was invented, or certain art or craft, etc. But what she said was something which was so interesting. She said that according to her, the human civilization start when a femur was healed. A femur is a broken thigh bone. Okay, so all of us have thighs, and we have thigh bones, and our thigh bone is called as a femur. And she said that, see, in the animal kingdom, if your thigh bone breaks, you can't move around. So you can't hunt. At the same time, you are also prey. You're also meat for a lot of other beasts. You can't go to the river and drink water. So your leg gets broken, you die. And that's why the expression break a leg comes, that, you know, like go kill them. You break a leg. So what she said is that if you break your leg, that means that you die. But if whenever the femur was broken, the person just died. But if there was a thigh bone that was healed, that meant that somebody took out time to stay behind, take the person who was hurt, take care of them, and nurse them through recovery. Okay? And that is when civilization started, because being there for others and helping them is when we are at our best. So when it comes to this time of corona, remember to help out other people. Don't be selfish. Don't let the fear in you come into you and rule you on a lot of levels. So it could also mean that, so I know a lot of people who are saying, who don't want to give tea to their watchman every day. Arre, hamari chai khatam ho jayegi toh. And we use Vagh Bakri, which is the most expensive of the tea. And we also don't have a lot of it. I mean, those watchmen are alone. And this is not a situation that really needs to be explained. So be there for other people in whatever manner that you can, because that is what being civilized means. And that is the only way that we can come out of corona well, by being there for each other.
Yeah, very well said, Nidhi. The next question is, there seems to be a subtle wave of panic in Unlock 1.0. While also hearing about tension on the borders and how India wants to establish its new endeavor of being Atmanirbhar, which requires us, the youth, also to be more adaptive, how do I bring about a sense of security for myself and even for the people around me?
So while this particular lady or gentleman is quite there, because, you know, you're thinking about the borders, you're thinking about the entire country. So that's amazing. Okay, and I'm so happy. And now the future is really looking bright with youngsters like this. So right. One way to be positive about this is to look at your own responsibility as a citizen, as a son, as a student. Okay? Try and everything starts small first. Family is the smallest of the unit of the entire society. So to be there for your country, you have to be there for your family. Okay? Ensure that you're helping them. Ensure that you're doing whatever you can for your housing society. Now, there are times a lot of us are short-staffed for the entire society. So if there is one watchman less, somebody has to go down in the morning, pani ka nal chalu karna hai, do that. Because that is how you're going to help your country, by helping your society, by helping your parents, by helping your college when they really need that. And the sense of panic is there, but don't spread the panic. If the panic comes to you, stop it there. Reassure the people. Okay, like the one particular person and the duck that we saw, that if people are saying, "Arey, I'm so scared, life is so scary now," we come and tell them life was always scary. We can take precautions. We can wear masks. We can practice social distancing, thing, whatever extent that we can do. And that way we are going to be there for each other. And that is what our responsibility is to ourselves, our family, and our country.
Yeah. Right. There is one question from a faculty member, Prachi Agarkar. How to overcome the burden of work from home stress plus doing the household chores, because many of us hardly get any time to indulge in any other activity.
True. So one of the ways, see, work from home is one of scary and I must say pretty ugly as a concept. And that is not something that a lot of us are able to deal with. One of the reasons is that earlier we could keep the personal and the professional life separate and we would be very strict about it, but now there is no such thing. Now, the most important thing is to put certain number of hours for work from home. Okay? You are not constantly all the time in front of the laptop that you're working something, you're putting an email, jao jaake tadka leke aao, then again you are done, you're again working on that email and you are doing that. So ensure that those hours that you are working from home, you are strictly working. I know when you are working with the team, this is something which is difficult to do, but it is difficult. It is not impossible. There are certain hours that you have to allocate. When it comes from home, the family members must chip in everything. There are so many tasks that children can do. When children are free at home, some of them have school, some of them, for that is also something which is stopped. We can't let them go out as yet. So sorting off things, folding clothes, cleaning or wiping off the clean vessels, sorting vessels. There are a lot of things that children can do. So every family member have to pick certain responsibilities, because that is the only way you can go ahead. Yes, the mothers are doing more than anybody else, but other people have to do more than what they did earlier. So you cannot be in a household which says, "Arey, dal chawal dinner mein to hamare ghar pe chalega hi nahi, humne kabhi nahi khaya." Lockdown bhi kabhi nahi hua hai. So you will have to try and do things that you have not done earlier. Another thing about work from home is that don't keep your laptop on all the time. So once your major work is done, switch it off. Keep a book or a journal, something around. Because what happens is that if it is on, you will be tempted to do small things. And if you go and do it if you go and approach it to do a small thing, you'll end up doing so much more. So when it comes to the laptop, if it is switched off, you're not going to switch it on. If the work is small, you can just make a note of it. So the next time that you switch on, you will check one particular mail, you will send one particular mail, you'll reply to something, you'll make that one change to the PPT that you had to. So keep a list handy and do a lot of things there. And another most important thing, don't work too late at night. Make sure you work only during working hours. If there is something that comes in perhaps late, I'm sure a lot of institutions overall work, they understand that late at night is not when the employees are going to work. So once you get into that discipline yourself, people around you will also start to reward it and they will call you at that particular time. Way before the lockout, we had one particular faculty in computers whose cell phone was always unavailable. Either we will be intercomming the labs in the college, and after 3:30 when he leaves every day, everybody knew that he was uncontactable. You want papers, you want something, your computer is, anything happens, he is not reachable. Yes, he lost out on, you know, messages from his friends, casual messages, but now everybody came to terms that this is how he is. Because once he would go home, he would keep his phone away because the time was for wife and family. So if he could do it, and there is so much that I have learned from him. So it takes a lot of discipline. It takes some time. People will murmur. They will talk about you, yes. But eventually you will get the schedule that you want.
Correct, Nidhi. The next question is, you can say it's from all of us, like parents as well as individuals have a fear of going out, especially looking at the rise in number of cases. How can we deal with this fear?
Now, see, there are two things here. One, going out even right now is for essential things only. Okay? So there used to be a song called Who Let the Dogs Out, you know, which was the visualization was very funny because some gate open and all the dogs just rush out. Okay? And we are not quite different, and it's not our fault. We have been jailed in our house for way too long. So we just want to go to Marine Drive and there breathe into the air. But remember that this is not something which is absolutely safe. So step out for the times that you absolutely have to. You can go to your building compound, or you can step out in the time which is not a very populated time, or you can go to your terrace. Those are the sources of your air that you have to. Again, family members can divide certain responsibilities or divide dates, that somebody would go and get this, or area wise they will go to the stationery, and if there is a vegetable market there, you go there. When you go there, take all the precautions, wear the mask, wear the gloves if you want to, once you come back, or if there are parcels which are coming at home delivery, keep them for some time, don't touch them for a few hours. If it is food, regardless of whatever it is, heat it, and if it is cooked food, heat it and eat it. So, and when it comes to children, be very, very careful. Don't say that, oh, somebody else went out. Oh, we are going to do that. Dekho, usko to kuch nahi ho raha. Even I want to go. They could have a better immunity than you have. So just because everybody is doing it, you don't have to do it. And for the essential services that you do, take all the possible precautions. Number one thing about fear is acknowledge the fear. All of us are scared, and we are scared for a reason, and we should be scared. There are so many people who are not scared. I am scared for so many people. You know, I see them just go out, aaj pizza khane ka man kar raha hai, and you're like, arre ghar pe baitho khao, varan baad khao, kya tumko farak pad raha hai. So try and step out only for things when you have to. And even when you do that, take as many precautions as you can. Make those precautions a part of your lifestyle. Jaise hi hum bahar se ghar pe aate hain, we take our shoes out. Do we ever forget to do that? Are we ever in a hurry that we don't take our shoes out? We always take our shoes out and then we step into the house. So that's the first thing we do when we step into the house. Similarly, when you're going to step out of the house, check for the mask. Check for the other things that you need, perhaps a glove, if you believe in sanitizer, or if you can carry hot water with you that you can sip occasionally, that is the best thing that could happen to you. So every day, twice a day, at a gap of 12 hours, you should have hot water. If you want, you can put nimbu in it, or if you can, if you want to put haldi or tulsi, whatever you like, put all those things in it. But make sure, so what one of the things that I recommend for people to do it is to do it every 12 hours. So 8 in the morning and 8 in the night, or 9 in the morning and 9 in the night, whichever 12 hours suit the best for you. Because once you do this, you will have a little bit of confidence in venturing out. And remember, this is about few more days or few more weeks. After that, the world is going to be safe again. And then we are just going to be out like no other. So all we need is just a little bit of patience.
Yeah, correct. The last question I will take now. The government hasn't given their verdict for final year examinations. And it has left many students anxious and stressed. What would your suggestions be for the students, and then for teachers or parents looking after students? Actually, this is for students as well as teachers and parents.
We were always, always more stressed about students' exams than students being stressed about their exams. Okay, so that is the universal truth. So one of the things is, I think the students have been incredibly well behaved this while. They have not started crazy Facebook campaigns, so they have somehow got their patience together. So I'm very, very happy at the mature behavior that they have come across. So
really,
far.
Really.
Yes.
Really.
So I actually thought that, you know, the groups will be buzzing and they will be calling, but they're pretty shunned. So I'm very, very proud of the students so far. And one thing that the students should remember is that when you look at the holistic perspective, there is the entire world, there is health and safety, there is economy, and then there is their exams. So as much as their exams are very, very important, safety is such a strong concern first. It won't be difficult to put an exam tomorrow, but we can't have 60 students in a class. And because that is also going to, that's what happened with France. They started their schools and the corona cases just went up, unfortunately. So one thing that the students must remember is, they are not alone. And it's not about that VSIT class that they are in. It is a crisis which is going through the entire city, the entire state, the entire country, the entire world. So those of the students who had their higher studies planned in India or abroad, wherever you wanted to apply, those people are going to understand. And while in this unbated limbo time period that you have, keep your books handy, get acquainted with your books, don't completely forget, because I know sometimes students, even what was done in past semester is like a pichla janam to them. They have no memory of us teaching that to them ever. So keep revising whatever that you have studied, because your exams, as the governor said, are going to happen. He has ruled that. So someday your exams are going to happen. So make sure your notes are handy. And this is an amazing time. Every till right from the time you were in the first time standard, you were saying thoda aur time hota, I would have been so well prepared. Thoda aur time hota. So now you've had months and months to prepare. You should all get O grade in that particular exam now. So and other time that you have, no, you can't study all 24 hours. I'm sure you can help your parents and other people at home. Try and get new skills, etc. Because we are indoors, so we have that time. So have that kind of faith. Anytime that you see that that faith thoda dagmaga raha hai, try and remember you are not alone. Ye jo sabka hoga, wahi aapka hoga, and you can't control what it is. If Varin could control the world, we would all sit and worry. There would be courses on how to worry so that you can excel at worrying, but that is not how it works. Okay, so and of course I like to wish all of you like a very very best of luck, because your exams are happening someday, but they're going to happen.
Very well answered, Nidhi. So these were all the questions. Thank you so much, Dr. Nidhi. I now request Khushi to present a vote of thanks. Over to Khushi.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello, audible? Yes.
Yes. Yes. Continue, dear.
Good evening, everyone. I, Khushi Sharma, Chair, WIE Affinity Group, IEEE VSIT Student Branch, would like to thank Dr. Thanawala for being a part of our event, Holistic Wellness in the Times of Corona. We are truly grateful for the valuable guidance you provided on how to navigate through these challenging times. Your talk reminded us that we can all come together and lend support to each other to bring strength, health, and more abundance to our lives. We thank you for helping us see importance of focusing on what makes us feel energized, connected, and empowered. I would also like to express my most sincere gratitude towards Principal of VSIT, Dr. Rohini Kelkar, Vice Principal, Mr. Asaf Rampurawala, and the management of Vidyalankar Gyanpeeth Trust for always supporting us in these endeavors and providing us with amenities to make them a success. Before we conclude this session, a note for the participants. You will find the link to the feedback form for this session in the chat box. Everyone is kindly requested to fill it before leaving the webinar. Emails will be sent to the registered attendees to fill the feedback in case you miss it here. Upon filling that, you shall receive your certificate. Please ensure you submit it by today. I would like to thank everyone for their active participation. It was a great pleasure to have you attend the event. Thank you.
So thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much, Nidhi.
Thank you, Sarika. Thank you, everyone.